You were a CEO of a big company, Celgene's big company, successful company. Give us a point of view from a CEO about how you regard all this trade talk.
Well, I think the talk is important. Free trade is so important to all of us in terms of growing the economy, more jobs, lower costs. So free trade is important, but fair trade is also important. I'm hopeful that all these discussions are really leading to solutions and better and fairer trade that will enhance trade and make it better for all of us. But we need trade. Trade's good for our country and all our citizens.
So as you travel in New Jersey, New Jersey exports a lot. So it can be very vulnerable if there is a trade war. What do you hear from constituents? I mean, how much satisfaction or dissatisfaction is there with the approach the administration is taking?
I think what I really hear about in New Jersey is somewhat New Jersey specific, because I think people are generally feeling the economy is doing well. There's optimism, lower unemployment. New Jersey is the higher end of the national averages. People just think New Jersey is so unaffordable. They're just so really concerned about the direction of the state, more so than the country right now.
Well, one of the things that's made it somewhat less affordable is the treatment for state and local taxes in the tax bill. I mean, people got tax cuts, but people in New Jersey, by the way, in New York and Connecticut, California,
same.
Didn't do so well as a practical matter. Is that an issue in this election for you? And particularly, it could hurt you because you're running as a Republican after all.
Yeah, no, I think the issue is an important one. About 62% of New Jerseyans are getting a tax cut on the federal level, about 29% no change, and 9% are getting a tax increase because of the cap on state and local tax deductions, like you said. But that's really a big issue because New Jersey is a state that really is suffering from out-migration, not just at the high end, which is critically important from the capital that the state loses, but New Jersey has the highest rate of out-migration of 18 to 34-year-olds. And those are the people that build the economy of the future. So New Jersey outlook for jobs is what people really want to hear about.
So let's be honest, you've got a little bit of an uphill battle. As I said, you haven't had a Republican representing in the Senate from New Jersey since 1972. What is your pitch? How do you ask for the order? Say, you should vote for me as opposed to my opponent because?
Well, I think you should look at the recent polls, right? The last poll was, I think, 4% plus or minus. So I think the people in New Jersey are pretty clear change is needed. Now, remember, my opponent, Bob Menendez, has been in Washington for 25 years, 16 of those years with a Democratic president, and New Jersey is dead last. We get the least back as a percentage from Washington of any state in the country. And rarely do you see bipartisanship in Washington. The Senate Ethics Committee bipartisanly said Senator Menendez violated federal law, abused the power of his office, disgraced the Senate, and it's a 40-year track record of corruption. It's too much. People in New Jersey have an opportunity to say it's time for change. And that's what we're hearing every day, every place we go in all 21 counties.
Is that the main issue at this point? It's integrity. And as you say, he was severely sanctioned. It was not just sanctioned, but severely sanctioned. Is that the main argument? You cannot return this man to the U.S. Senate?
Well, I think that's one of the two. One is he's failed us. He's embarrassed us. But he's failed to deliver for the people. New Jersey is not a wealthy state. And we're being last after 25 years there. It's time for change.
Well, let's talk about what you might be able to do for New Jersey. Trains and transit and tunnels and things like that that you basically haven't gotten done in New Jersey, not you personally, but in New Jersey. Do you have any realistic prospect of getting that done in the Trump administration if you were to be elected to the U.S. Senate?
I think we need to have creative solutions. Infrastructure is one of the most important things in New Jersey. You don't have to be in New Jersey very long to see the congestion. It affects quality of life. We need to improve infrastructure. We need creative solutions, public-private partnerships. But also we need Washington to invest more in New Jersey. New Jersey's been the centerpiece of our economy in our country. Think about the benefit to New York, to New England, mid-Atlantic states out west. New Jersey's been a centerpiece, center crossroads of our economy for 100 years. We've invested in it. Now the rest of the country needs to invest more in New Jersey.
As you run your campaign, are you running with President Trump or against President Trump? Because I've seen your ads, and you go out of your way to say, look, I make my own mind up. Doesn't matter with the Republicans or Democrats.
Yep. You know, I've been independent all my life. I'm going to do what's best for New Jersey. New Jersey's taken the back seat for too long. In Washington, we need better, stronger representation for New Jersey first. If anybody supports New Jersey, I'm going to be with them. Anybody has policies that are not good for New Jersey, I'm going to stand up against them. It's time to put New Jersey first.
And finally, let's talk about money, because as a practical matter, whether it's good or bad, you need to have a fair amount of money to run for Senate in this country today, okay? Where are you on money? Where is your opponent? How is your money raising going?
Well, I'll tell you, the July 15th, I think, is the next time we report, June as of June 30th. My wife and I, we've made a significant commitment to make sure the people of Jersey will have an opportunity to hear the message clearly, the contrast on character and integrity, and the failure to deliver, and my track record of producing bipartisan collaborative outcomes. And so we're going to make sure the resources are there to make sure the people of New Jersey are going to hear the message.